you to get back up and tell yourself that you are a conqueror and you will overcome everything. You understand me? I need you to get in your word, and I need you to learn your word, because no weapon formed against you shall prosper. That weeping may endure in the night, but your joy cometh in the morning. I want you to realize that you ain't too gangster. You ain't too hood to serve God. Because guess what? Even the ones with the money going through something mentally, you got to realize you can have all the money in the world, but you still ain't happy. Because money buy you what you want. But I need God in my life, because I'm rich in the spiritual realm. And being rich in the spiritual realm get open doors for me. Being rich in the spiritual realm do things that, guess what, money can't do. But let me tell you something here. They can look at the outside of you, but guess what? They don't know what you endured in the inside of you. Let them talk. Let them talk. Let them talk. Let them talk. They big mad. And guess what? The devil gonna be even big madder. The devil gonna be even big madder. Tell him you big man now. You big man. Because guess what? You should have loved me when you had me. You should have accepted me when you had me, baby. I was the best friend you ever had. I was the goodest woman. I was the goodest man. I was the goodest everything to you. But you fumbled the bag. You fumbled me. How y'all say fumbled the bag? They fumbled you. You understand me?
Yeah.
They fumbled you, baby. I got to get to your level, and I got to speak on your level. Because God already knows what type of folks that's following me. I can serve God, but I can also explain it to you in a way that you will understand it. Because there's a lot of y'all that's still out here. It's a lot of y'all still out here doing what y'all doing. It's a lot of y'all out here that need to know and understand, baby. And guess what? I'm going to tell you like this. It won't always be like this. Because sooner or later, it's going to work in your favor.
Mm-hmm.
Sooner, you tell yourself, you tell yourself, what have you accomplished being around the folks that you're around? I need you to think about that question. What have you accomplished being around the same folks you've been around? Because at the end of the day, when you know you have a vision, shut up, princess. When you know you have a vision, why would you want to be around people who don't have the same vision as you? Why you want to be around folks who don't see the goodness in you? You understand? Like, a lot of people be like, well, Miss April, I know you don't be around a lot of friends. I've been hurt. You understand? I've been used. And everybody that's up against me, you got to be mindful of what you say. You got to be mindful of what you say about God's children, honey, especially the chosen ones. You got to be mindful, baby. You got to be mindful how you put your mouth on me. You got to be very mindful how you put your mouth on me, baby. He said, touch not my anointing. Do my prophet no harm. So you got to be careful what you say about me. You got to be careful, because everybody that making them fake pages and doing all that type of stuff, baby, guess what? Everything they touch ain't going to prosper. Because I'm going to tell y'all something. When you're doing something so positive, it's always going to be a negative. You understand? You keep doing you. I ain't stopped yet. And I ain't stopping. Guess what? The devil mad, and you're going to be big mad. Because what God has for me, for me. Y'all can make all the fake pages you want to. You can try to scale, but you ain't going to scale too long, because you're going to get caught. And guess what?
You're exactly.
He don't play. He don't play. He don't play when it comes to me. I'm just being like, he don't play when it comes to y'all neither. But he don't play.
play when it come to me. He don't play when it come to me. So be mindful. Be mindful what you say about. I start revealing your fake friends. He start revealing everybody. Everybody you thought was for you gonna be in your dream. And everybody you thought was gonna be at, congratulations. That finish line ain't gonna be the one that you think for you, baby. They gonna be cut off so quick. You gonna be pray like this, God. If they for me, it'll be for me. But if they ain't for me, God, move them out of my life where it won't hurt me nor offend me. And guess what God'll do? God'll move that man like this. God'll move that woman like this. God'll move them people like this. You don't even know when they move because they don't call your phone. You won't even feel it. That's how smooth God is. You understand? That's how smooth he is. You won't even know. They don't even call you no more. You be like, dog. Damn. Later on, you be thinking about it. You be like, dog, nobody don't call my phone no more. Well, they understand without me. But then you have to think about it, what you prayed about. You understand? It's a lot of things that we want God to do, but we got to be honest with God. You understand? Like, that's just like something you know you need. You understand? If you know you need a new car, you know you got to save your money to get that new car. If you know you need a new house, you know you're going to work on your credit to get that new house. You feel me? But you're going to put your best foot forward to get the house and that car. That's the same thing you do for God. You understand? You fight for it. You fight for that relationship and you keep it. And you tell people about Jesus. Tell them. Don't you never be scared, because guess what? When you out here slanging and doing all type of thing and laying up with this type of man and laying up with type of that woman, you think about when you land up with them and when they can.
When you're living in sin, you just lay up.
You don't think about you at that time. You don't even think about your health. You ain't even think of it. Anxiety is a spirit. I'm just being honest. That's a spirit, honey. That it ain't nothing that's going on. You healthy. That's a spirit. You need to pray. Pray. And when I say pray, don't half pray. I mean whole pray. Sometimes, baby, you can't run to everybody for prayer. I ain't gonna say I'm good. You understand me? I pray for you. I'm gonna pray for you. But baby, you gotta learn to have a relationship with God and pray for yourself, because God, the only God can bring you out of it. If you go in that closet or wherever you at, go in there and pray and ask God to release that from you. Release it from you. And watch what God do. Watch what God do for you.
Yep. He definitely will.
Yeah, I am. You said it, you prayed and it didn't work. Oh, Lord. How much faith do you have that God will do it? You, right now, you in between of doubting God. You doubt God. You doubt him. Because a lot, let me tell you something. It's a lot of stuff that we feel like, God, why? Why we go through this?
Yeah.
Why are we going through it? Mentally, baby, you got to get your mental. You got to stay in your word. You got to pray. When I say pray, you got to pray. Because God knows if you genuinely mean it or not.
Yeah.
You could say you do it all you want to, baby. You could tell me something, but let me tell you something. God know. People be sitting up here, and I'm just being honest. God know you now. He can see right through you. He know you before. He know what you're going to think before you think it.
Yeah.
He know what you're going to do before you do it.
Yeah.
You understand? So you may say, God ain't doing it. He said, ye of little faith. Ye. God said, ye of little faith. Your faith little is big. My faith big. When I asked God to bring me out of he had to bring me out of, guess what I did? I would cry so hard. I would cry from my soul. I promise you, I would cry from my soul.
Yeah.
And guess what he did?
He brought you up.
And guess what? I ain't had to worry about it no more. I ain't had to worry about it no more, because this time, when I cried that time, he knew I was for real.
Yeah.
The other few times, he probably like, child, boo, I see you. I see right through you, honey. And guess what? When I cried that time, sincerely from my heart, he said, okay, I know this time she for real. Last time she was for real. She gonna slip and fall, and I know that. You know, so at the end of the day, we have to get to a point where we be around people that can focus on our mental, because when you be around people who carry so many spirits, who carry so much negativity, that follows you.
Mm-hmm.
It follows you. So you want to be around people right. Sometimes you pray and you ask for things that God, and one thing about God, he loves us so much that he protects us. You understand? He protects us from things. Because we'll ask God for a certain thing and he'll be like, you don't need that. We'll ask God to do a certain thing, but I know. I ain't finna do that. I ain't finna do that for you, because you gotta realize in life, God can see things we can't see.
Yep.
And it's a blessing that we can have, right? And God will hold that blessing. The reason why God will hold that blessing, because sometimes in life, it's just like money. Some of y'all been waiting on money for years.
Yep.
God ain't gonna release that money.
Yeah.
He's not going to release that money until you surround yourself by people that he see with a vision. You, because the people that you got going to take. But after God said, I'm tired of the people taking from you, so I'm going to separate you from the takers and bring the givers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to bring the folks that can pull you. I'm going to bring the folks that can tap you. I'm going to bring the folks that can intercede for you. I'm going to bring the folks that can pray for you. I'm going to bring the folks that no matter what time of the hour, baby, they coming through for you. I'm going to send the folks that if you fall down and down tomorrow, they're going to pick you up. I'm going to send the folks that's not going to judge you. I'm going to send the folks that, guess what, if you call, whatever it is you want to do, they there for you. So as I separate you from people, it's going to hurt. As I separate you from things, it's going to hurt. As I separate you from the people that's steady hurting you, it's going to hurt. Even the man that you say love you ain't the man for you. Because sometimes we think the man for us ain't the man who God's son. That sometimes, guess what, you can leave a relationship and a devil and reverse it to the same familiar spirit, but just a different body. Is somebody listening to me? The same familiar spirit, just a different body. Be mindful.
mindful with who you call, mindful with who you vent to, mindful with who you trust, mindful with who you, baby, mindful with who you do anything with, because everybody that you think for you is not for you. Everybody that you think that's going to stand in the corner with you is not going to stand in the corner with you. People that you think genuinely care for you, do they really care?
Nope. They don't.
It get lonely.
Yes, it do.
But I'd rather be lonely than to be with a room full of people and I'm broken.
Mm-hmm.
I'd rather be lonely than be with a man that's steady breaking me. Exactly. I'd rather be lonely than to be in a house full of people that don't love me. I'd rather be lonely. Let me tell you something. I'd rather be lonely in this season of my life and find out who I am than be in a season of my life where I can't find out who I am. Because guess what? We be sometimes in life, we be around people and things that hinder us. And, yep. And God, I ask that you separate me. I ask that you restore the righteousness in me. God, I ask that you purify me. I ask that you separate me from people and things that don't mean no good. God, I ask that you pull on me. I ask that you get me and pick me. See, guess what? Well, sometimes in life, you got to realize that many, it's a many people that be around you, but is they caring like you? Do they love like you? Do they fight like you? Do they pray like you? Do they intercede like you? Do they see the vision like you? Do they want greater for you? You gotta be around friends, folks that see the vision and that love you. People that can speak life in you. People that can guess what, move you. I need people in my life that can move me, God. I need people in my life, God, that can turn the building upside down. You said one, two, or three are gathered. I am there also. I need you to change the mind frame. I need you to change the heart, God. I need you to even cover my friends, even though they're not for me. I ask that you protect them. He said, pray for those who scandalize your name and do you wrong. So, God, I'm in a season of my life I ask for forgiveness. And, God, I gotta take full accountability for the things that I do. See, when you learn to take full accountability for the things that you do, then you woman and man enough to stand up. You woman and man enough to admit your wrong. You woman and man enough to say, I may have said some things to you. I'm sorry for what I said. I may have done some things to you. And if I did something to you, I'm sorry. If I did something to break you, I'm sorry. If I did something to put you in a place to make you uncomfortable, I ask that God put you in a place to make you comfortable. Because sometimes in life, we don't understand what we do. Sometimes in life, we don't understand what we say at that time. But let me tell you something about the enemy. The enemy allows you to say things to break somebody. Because somebody